Welcome. Let's see 7 new features in Excel. All these features are on browser version. Maybe they'll come to desktop later, but browser we can start using straight away. Many avid users of Excel think that browser version they don't need to use. They are experts, so they will use desktop. That may be true, but there are genuine reasons why you should prefer browser version in some cases. I'll tell you those reasons at the end. But let's get started with the new features. The first one is really powerful. Adding columns or rows is a common activity. How do we add normally? Right click and then add. Okay, now look at this. I went to the column to right click, but before I could right click, as soon as the mouse reached there, I see 2 holes on either side. So it's asking me, do you want to add a column on the left side or right side? So go there, take the cursor, and there you get a plus sign. Just click there and it simply adds a column. What if I select multiple columns and then click on that? Of course, it is going to add more columns. Same thing works with rows as well. The next thing is unhiding columns. Hiding, of course, you know how to do. You select something, right click and hide. Earlier, unhiding column required you to select the adjacent ones, right click, and it could get very confusing. Now what do you do? I know there is a hidden column there. I do not have to select anything. Everything is about mouse movement. Look at the mouse cursor. That's the way to learn, by the way, even on desktop version. Many expert thinks that mouse, if you touch, you're not a good Excel user. No, that's absolutely wrong. Of course, you should know shortcuts. And if you want to work faster, you will automatically learn shortcuts. But there are certain things mouse is very good at, and you should not have any bias against mouse versus keyboard. Anyway, so I'm just taking the mouse cursor here, and then look at what happened. It's showing me this. Click to unhide. There's a little bug there. There should be a white background, but never mind. I'm sure Microsoft will correct it. And then click on it, and it's back. The next one is equally common as far as requirements go. Very often we need to rearrange columns. We get data from all over the place and it is dumped from some system. And then we don't like the order of things. What do we do? Well, we select the columns, then we right click, then we cut it and then go somewhere and paste it. And it is not a smooth operation. Now what do we do? Well, you select the columns anyway because you have to decide what you want to move. But again, look at the mouse cursor. This mouse cursor means I can select a cell. This mouse cursor means it has something to do with the column. But now in between this and this, slowly becomes a hand. And while it is a hand, if you drag, you see how beautifully it is allowing you to rearrange columns. And while you are dragging, it's telling you this is going to insert. So nothing is going to get deleted. But suppose I wanted to overwrite, no problem. I select, make sure the cursor is a hand and drag. And before you release it, what do I do? Press the shift key. It's a destructive operation. It needs one more round of permission from you, which is fine. And then say replace. Job done. Now there's like a move operation. So this became empty now. So there you have it. Rearranging columns has become easier. One word of caution. When you are moving this data, it is not only data here. If there was data below, that is also going to move. So be careful while doing that. It's not going to give you a warning saying there is unrelated data below. Now, although this is a great feature, if you get raw data and you want columns in a particular way, remember that raw data is going to come next week, next month. So this may be good for one-off things. If you have repetitive data cleanup requirements, do not do it manually. Always use Power Query. So Power Query, you configure whatever you want, tell Power Query which orders of columns, and next time you just have to refresh as long as the path remains the same. The next one is freeze pane. I know the spelling is wrong. I've put it intentionally because freezing rows and columns is a pain anyway. But now the pain is a little less because we have another mouse-based method. Take the mouse cursor. By now, you know, you see border, thick border. Just take the mouse cursor there. Again, it changes to hand and then glue. Drag it down. Now, this is frozen. So simple. Amazing. Same thing works vertically as well. Done. And how will you get rid of it? No, double click doesn't work on browser. Just drag it back. Oh, by the way, freeze pane, if you are doing it just because you want these headers to be always visible, I hope you know there is a better way. What is that? Create a table. When it is a table, when you scroll, that ABCD is gone and it's replaced with the header. In fact, on the browser version, even if your cursor is not inside the table, it stays. On the desktop version, only if your cursor is in the table, it'll replace. If you click outside, it'll not. Browser version is even smarter. Here is another simple one. Rename a sheet. Desktop version, we can just double click and name it. Now you can do it on browser as well. That's it. Easy, effective. Now, do you know that you can copy a link not just to a file, but to a sheet as well? So I right click here, copy link to this sheet. Another option is go to file, share, and then you can copy link to workbook. Okay, so I'm going to do this for a sheet. I'm copying link, and then what do I do? I can go to somewhere else and paste the link. I think the link gets pasted. So what is the big deal? The big deal is when you hover on the link, it gives you ability to copy, edit the link settings, or even remove the link. And if it was a desktop file and it has a preview, then that preview image will also be shown. Another useful feature is I can copy paste sheets. Just right click on a sheet, choose copy sheet, right click on another sheet and say paste. This will work only within the workbook, not across workbooks. And this cannot be undone. You can only copy one sheet at a time. Multiple selection and copy paste is available only in the desktop version. So those are the seven new features. But before you go, let me tell you when it is recommended or desirable to open Excel and edit Excel on browser version. First thing is, if it's a very large file, it's going to take time to open on desktop. So if it is a large file and you just want to look at some data or a chart or make few minor changes, then it's easier, faster, and more convenient to open it on browser. Remember, many people are suffering from older versions of Excel on the desktop. So if you have any version with a year number in it, like 2013, 16, 19, those are older desktop-oriented versions. They are not optimized to work with cloud fully. So if some people are editing on the Office 365 version, some people on older version, there may be conflicts or file corruption or some other goof-ups. So what is the best practice? If you have mixed versions of Excel and these kind of problems are occurring, recommend that at least while editing is happening together, everyone uses the browser version. Now you will not have any problem. Is there are some features which are only available on browser and new features come to browser version first. So what is the feature available only on browser? Is you have created some report and it's a nice graphic or a visual chart, something like that, and you want to put it on your website or blog. No copy paste, live data. How do you do that? Go to share button and say embed. It'll give you a nice embed code which you put it in your blog. Now for this to work, whoever is looking at your blog should have permission, or it should be anonymous access, then it will work beautifully. So there you have it, seven new features plus many more useful things in Excel. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.